of class 8 standard in social science we are going to deal with a very important branch that is called as civics. Okay my dear students, in civics the first chapter is like this, the Indian constitution, and this is your part 8 video. So children, this is your the lesson ending video. Okay, so here in today's class we are going to discuss about the cultural and educational rights which comes under the article 29 to 30. Then along with this children, here the second point is like this, right to constitutional remedies that comes under the article 32. Okay, so here before discussing today's point, so let us have a quick glance what I discussed in the previous class children. Okay, so in the previous class I discussed about the right to freedom. So I have given the heading, that is right to freedom and cultural and educational rights. But only one point I have highlighted. So that is right to freedom. So children, here right to freedom of religion. So as we know that children, here we are living in a secular country. So here no national religion is there children. All religions are equal. Okay. So we are living in a diverse country. So only our country is called as a unity in diversity. Okay my dear students, so here the Indian constitution, it has given religious freedom to its citizen by protecting their rights. Okay, so how the Indian constitution is going to protect the rights? Well children, here the Indian constitution has given the provision that the citizens of India, as per their convenience, they can follow any religion. Okay, so along with this children, here it has clearly mentioned that the citizens should not pay any kind of taxes, for the management of the temples and the worship centers. Okay, so along with this children, here the constitution also has restricted to use the religious center for the political and other activities. So all these things comes under the right to religious freedom. Okay, so in today's point we are going to discuss that is called as cultural and educational rights, which falls under the article 29 to 30. Okay my dear students, so here you can see that all citizens of the country, they have their own language, culture and traditions. They have their own language, culture, tradition, script. Okay, so here it is the duty of the state to protect them, to protect the languages, script. Okay children, so here this right protects the interest of the religious or linguistic minorities, and no one can be denied admission in a government added institution. So I will write here children for your convenience. So here this right is going to be that the state government protects the interest of the linguistic minorities. So here children, along with this, no one can be denied, no one can be refused to take admission, no one can deny to take admission in a government or added institution. Okay, there is entry and admission for each and every citizen. So here no one can be denied, no one can refuse to take admission in a government or added institution which is going to run by the minorities. Minorities means children here, the backward. Okay, so I hope up to here the concept is clear. So once again I am going to repeat all my points here children. So this is the fifth right of, sorry, this is the fourth right of the fundamental right of the citizens children here. Cultural and educational rights, which comes under the article 29-30. So children here, it is going to ensure that the state government protects the interest of the linguistic minorities. Linguistic minorities in the sense you can call that children here, OBC people will come, okay? The Muslims will come, the Sikhs will come, the Christian people will come, okay? So here, along with this children here, no one can deny to take admission. No one is going to deny, refuse to take admission in a government or added institution which is going to run by a minorities. Okay? So I hope this concept is clear. We will move forward. competition, peer criteria and covariance. So through this the fundamental rights are going to be protected. Okay my dear students, so once again I am going to repeat all my points here. Please check out all these points. So here children, I talk about right to constitutional remedies. So when I talk about the right to constitutional remedies, this comes under the Article 32. Okay. So then along with this children here, I also said that here if a person he feels that his rights are, his fundamental rights are in danger, so he can go along with this. For this purpose, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, called it as a heart and soul of the constitution. Heart and soul of the constitution. Okay. So along with this student here, I also said that Supreme Court has a power as a power to protect the fundamental rights through right to constitutional remedies. My dear students, so I hope the concept is clear. Okay, so here your lesson, the Indian Constitution, this is totally over, and please send it your question answers in a PDF format. Okay, thank you for watching this video children. So I will be along with you with a new concept. Until then, take care of yourself.